Good morning, Vital Men. It's good to be with you on this Monday. As we continue our series, The Kingdom of God, one of the guys that we're going to talk about today is King David. And this is at the very beginning of, he starts his going into leading the army, also to being part of Saul, and also to at this point, he's actually a young man, almost considered a boy. And it's interesting as King Saul, he's facing at the Valley of Elah, he's facing the Philistines and also facing an incredible giant by the name of Goliath. So he goes and they sit there and the Philistines continue to taunt the Israel army. And they go too far as to say, if you want to go to fight in the battle, if you just simply want to fight man to man, we're going to send out Goliath. And any man that's brave enough to go against our giant, if you win, we'll bow to you. If we win, you bow to us. Well, obviously, King Saul wasn't going to do that, but at the same time, it says in the Bible that he was absolutely scared to death. He was frozen in the midst of the moment. And that's what happens a lot of times when we go against giants in our lives. We come against giants that freeze us in moments, in places of whatever it might be. It might be financial, sometimes it's marriage, sometimes it's within our jobs. It's so many different things that just freeze us in the midst of moments. But I want to tell you something. This is what David does. I want to read out of the Bible, out of 1 Samuel chapter 17. I love this response of what David does. He says this, David asked the soldier standing nearby and asking, what will a man get for killing this Philistine and ending this defiance of Israel? Who is this pagan Philistine anyway that he has allowed to defy the armies of the living God? You know, David, he's pretty got a lot of spunk going on at this moment, and he's ready for battle. And in my mind, he's so young, maybe he doesn't realize. But at the same time, it says the favor of the Lord, the spirit of the Lord was upon David. And as we know, in the Valley of Elah, he goes out and he slays the giant. Now, I was very fortunate a few years ago going to Israel that I was actually at the Valley of Elah, and I saw those two mountains, one on each side. And I could only imagine what it must have been like for those two armies to be chanting back and forth against each other. But in the Valley of Elah, there is actually that same creek that's still there, and all kinds of rocks in the midst of that creek. I tell you what, when I jumped out of the van, man, I was running as hard as I could for that creek because I was going to find some smooth rocks. Rocks that possibly, that maybe King David might have even seen with his own eyes in the Valley of Elah. You know, man, we always have giants. But if we're going to truly face the kingdom of God and the kingdom of God moments, we've got to be able to face our giants and allow the Holy Spirit to work through us. So our decree today is, we decree today that God is greater than any of the giants that come against us, that we can face them with the power and the spirit of the Holy Spirit himself and go against the giants of our lives. Men, face your giants. Strength and courage. Fear not. As David said, he's going to destroy against the uncircumcised Philistine. So can we. Have a great day.